My name is Sunil Wadhwani. I am the founder donor of Wish Foundation based in New Delhi. Primary healthcare, as we know, is the foundation of healthcare. To have an effective healthcare system overall, you need an effective primary healthcare system. Now, in many parts of India, primary healthcare has made significant progress, especially if we look at the states in southern India, states in western India, and some of the states in northern India. Many of the large, low-income states in India still have a long way to go. The good news is that the leadership, the governments in these states recognize that the primary healthcare system in these states does need a lot of improvement. They are very open to new ideas on how to make these changes. And the biggest thing I think people are seeing now is how technology and innovation can play a very big part in improving primary healthcare. So the nonprofit foundation that I founded 4 years ago, the Wish Foundation, our mission is to work with government to help government achieve its healthcare goals for the citizens of India. We focus on improving primary healthcare and improving it through applying game-changing technology and innovation. Our goal is that by the year 2027, which is, of course, the 80th anniversary of India's independence, that everyone in India will have access to good quality primary healthcare, regardless of their income level. So we call that goal Healthy India at 80. The way we apply technology and innovation to improve primary healthcare at Wish Foundation is the following. Healthcare has different components to it. There's a preventive component, there's a diagnostic component, there's a treatment component, there's a follow-up component. We bring technology to strengthen each of these areas. So as an example, on the diagnostic side, in the health and wellness centers that we run, the primary health centers that we run, a lot of the diagnostics on patients are run on smart, intelligent diagnostic devices, which can take the data from the patient, transmit it to physicians who might be remote, and then use that data to come up with the best treatment options for the patient. On the treatment side, there are many areas in India, especially in rural parts of India, where physicians aren't available. So we use telemedicine, again, technology, as a way of making physicians available to patients so that they don't have to wait, so they can get consultations right off the bat. All of this can be taken to an even higher level by applying technologies like artificial intelligence to this, because then all the data that we gather can be analyzed using artificial intelligence techniques to then start predicting which individuals are more likely to get sick, when disease breaks out. AI can help predict when it might break out, where it might break out, and hence enable the government and private sector to then take actions to reduce the scope of that breakout. So there is a lot that's possible, and in India, we're just at the very early stages of applying technology and innovation into primary healthcare. And I believe in the next few years, we will see a huge amount of progress, and we hope that our NGO, Wish Foundation, will play a big part in this. And interestingly, we at Wish Foundation have developed the first models of technology-enabled health and wellness centers. So in fact, this is brand new. We have 10 of these centers running right now in rural Rajasthan. And in just the next 90 days, we are expecting to take this number to over 100 technology-enabled health and wellness centers. This model is getting a lot of attention from many state governments in India, and we're speaking with many of them and seeing how we can assist them in rolling out this kind of model. We've started working with several states in rolling out technology-enabled primary health centers and health and wellness centers. So we're doing this in Rajasthan, in Delhi NCR region, in Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana. In fact, right now, our Wish Foundation is running over 300 primary health clinics in these areas. Last year, we treated over 4 million people with free healthcare through these technology-enabled centers that we have, and the results are quite remarkable. In the areas where we work, we're seeing immunization levels going up, outpatient volume going up dramatically because people now know that they will be attended to. We're seeing antenatal care, postnatal care, those visits going up. So all of the metrics are going up very nicely thanks to the introduction of technology. So now, as I said, this is getting a lot of attention from many other states, and we're hoping we'll be able to expand this model dramatically in the next 2 or 3 years. Artificial intelligence really can have a dramatic impact on how we address healthcare in India. And interestingly, I think we can become very quickly the leading country in the developing world on how AI is being applied to improve healthcare. So for example, TB. TB is a huge concern in developing countries. It's a huge concern in India. About almost 2 million people contract tuberculosis in India every year. Almost 500,000 people die every year. So it is a disease that causes a lot of tragedy. AI, artificial intelligence, can help dramatically in multiple areas in helping to detect and treat tuberculosis. So for example, one of the first things that's done when someone is suspected of having TB is taking a sputum sample and then analyzing that sample. We at Wish Foundation and at our sister institute called the Wadhwani Institute for Artificial Intelligence, we have developed algorithms that automate this process of sputum analysis. Right now, we don't have enough people in India who can do this analysis. Well, our artificial intelligence algorithms can do it as well as human beings can. That's one example. X-ray analysis. So when someone has TB, at the early stages of TB, they get this little spot on the x-rays in their lungs, which can often be very difficult for human beings to spot. AI can be trained and algorithms can be developed to spot that very early on. You've heard of MDR-TB, multiple drug-resistant TB, which is affecting an increasing number of people. Right now, about 5% of TB patients get MDR-TB, but they account for almost half of the overall costs spent in India on TB. So it's a huge issue, and of course, it's a lot of tragedy for these families. The challenge with MDR-TB is that the complex cocktails of drugs that are needed for each patient to help treat them, it varies almost on a patient-by-patient basis. And it can be very complicated coming up with the right combinations. Artificial intelligence can make a huge difference in analyzing and coming up with these combinations very quickly. So just a few examples of how AI can be transformative with TB. On the primary health side, there are just numerous applications where AI can be used. So as an example, right now we've got about 1 million ASHA workers in India working at the front lines. ASHA workers work extremely hard. They are overloaded. They are stretched. They don't have enough time for what they do. They're required to go out, meet a number of patients every day, analyze their conditions, give immediate feedback. Artificial intelligence available to them through their phones, through their cellular phones, can be a tremendous source of assistance to these ASHA workers as they go out. So as they talk to patients, hear about the conditions, the AI programs on their smartphones, which are very easy to use, can help the ASHA worker decide very quickly which cases are less serious, which cases are more serious, whether serious cases, what exactly type of follow-up should you be doing. Training of ASHA workers, of ANMs, of Anganwadi workers, etc., can be taken to a much higher level using AI. And of course, when you get to the primary health clinics themselves, AI can be transformational in terms of disease detection, in terms of coming up with the right treatment plans, whole range of areas. So over the next 2, 3, 4 years, you will see a lot of change in healthcare happening in India thanks to the use of AI.